in my talk today on lessons learned from a non-linear career trajectory, I started with an outline of my career path because it was very non-linear, and then I pulled out several different issues that I thought might be useful to discuss with people who are at an earlier stage in their career trajectory. So a linear career path usually goes from high school to undergraduate to graduate school and on to the career. In my case, I had a family first, then went to undergraduate and then graduate, then over to Germany and then back to graduate school, and then hired at Penn and then over to IBM and then back to Penn and then up the more traditional trajectory. There are a variety of ways that the career path can veer from being linear. You can have an opportunity to do an exciting project that you hadn't anticipated. It might take you in a different direction in your research. You might have an opportunity to think about an industry career when you originally thought you were going to be on an academic track and find that very stimulating and go off in that direction as well. So those are just two examples. Examples involving leadership can happen later in your career. It's not really possible to prepare for your career path taking a turn. However, if you have developed a strong network of mentors that you can rely on for advice and a infrastructure that you can take advantage of that can give you resources to help think through some of the challenges in a career change, that can be really beneficial. I hope that people took away from this talk that the geometry of your career trajectory doesn't define your success, and that there are many opportunities and resources, particularly if you network and have mentors, that can help you work through those.